This time it took me less than 3 minutes to remember that we need to switch course in order to play this video game. So I haven't looked up how long this game is, so it's quite possible we're like 5 minutes away from completing it. It's also possible we're 15 hours away from completing it. Who knows? Not me. All right, so I think I parked over here because this is the next place where the plot is. So just to remind myself that this is where we should be going. It's not where we're going because we're definitely going to do everything else possible before doing the plot. Now let me check my screenshots here, because I think I have a couple of treasure hints that we didn't pick up last week. Okay, so we have one I didn't get. But do we also have a map? Okay, cool. I remembered on the first try which button takes us back into the ship. All right, this is the northern continent, I think. That it? Maybe? That might be it. Let's find out if this was it. Which button is scan? Scan, all right. I appreciate the dot 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 question mark at the end of that. Maybe? I guess we'll just have to find out. I mean, we won't find out because we can't actually use any of these items we pick up. But we'll sell it to a guy. So the one text hint I have is a platinum lantern is buried in one of its four legs. Is that the dog? I think that's the dog. Where's the dog? It is indeed dog time. The time for dog. Sell this junk to this guy. Hope you enjoy your curse. So, did you find a platinum lantern? That's great. So, no new intel there. It's the hidden village. This isn't a town, but I haven't been here in a minute, so I don't know if there's anything different here. I think this person was here before. I think the start of what that guy said was the same as before, but this is definitely new. And I absolutely love to hear about treasure. Two-part clue. So I have no idea what the inland sea this guy is referring to is. Okay, hand is still there. Kind of looks like a goofy monster face, but I don't think that's it. It says we should be looking at it from the southeast. So that would be this direction. That's probably not it. There's a lot of water around, but I have no idea what specifically would be the inland sea. We'll shelve that one for now. Okay, I was expecting a treasure hint, but no, he's just giving me what those islands are called. Cool. Okay, got a map. Nice. Let's come back anyway. All right, that is not very specific. Wanted to look at what equipment I had because I didn't remember what I have left to upgrade. I'm at the maximum engine and maximum rudder. But I'm only at this one in the armor. It's cost, yeah, a lot of money. Weapon, we're only at number two. Weapon also pretty pricey. Is this it? I think this might be it. Yeah, okay. Was indeed just an indistinct bit of the continent there. I'll get to it. Some gems, yes. I love knowing where gems probably are. Forest around the Doom Triangle somewhere? Enchanted ring intel. Yep, give me that. Sneak up on the angry sea god. I have no idea what that means. Let me see if this guy had any more. I think I checked. Torn in the Valley of the Mountains. There's more than one place that could be. Doom Triangle is not that direction. Okay. Doom Triangle's over here. So, large secluded forest. Here, maybe this forest next to it? That's pretty out of the way. Nice. Right, so like here's a valley between mountains. It doesn't appear to be that one. Maybe it's the real weird one down here. Maybe there's something finally here. Nice. All right. I checked this one constantly last week because there absolutely had to be something here, and there's finally something here. So we have the road to sneak up on the angry sea god. And I have absolutely no idea whatsoever what that could possibly mean. Maybe that's referring to the Doom Triangle? The angry sea god, not referring to like something that looks like that, but rather the part of the sea where everyone crashes and dies. Nothing on the cape there. Maybe this one? Nope, not that either. I didn't think it was going to be this one because this was really close to this thing that we just got earlier. And I didn't think there would be two like that close next to each other. Okay, cool. Sure. One of the valleys, okay. Yeah. All right. That's cryptic. We'll buy your map too. Sure, why not? More maps, absolutely. Gimme, 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 gimme. Now, it's here. Three islands similar in shape southeast of here. Third Age Islands. Thinking these might be the parent, grandparent, grandchild islands. The southeast of here. So these? There's finally something on the Drumstick Island. I guess they are all vaguely drumstick shaped. These two are in the same orientation, and this one is rotated. Is this one Lando's base? Yes, okay. So gold is hidden in one of the valleys around here. There are a lot of valleys, as you can see, so we might be here for a while. Right, we're not here for a while. Love not being here for a while. Literally just some gold bars. Got him. Right, more maps. Guess we should open up the map compartment in our ship and actually take a look at what we've got here. Oh, yeah. We have to find the letter E. And we have to find whatever this is. Okay, this actually looks like an island. I don't know which one, but certainly an island. Very islandy. Looks like a standalone island with a forest on it. Maybe this one? Is that what that looked like? Yeah, I think this is it. Goes over here. Yeah. I found the island that actually looks like an island, as opposed to the two islands that look like geometric shapes. A big round guy and the letter E. Letter E, probably not the okay hand. The Blobby Island is sort of similar in shape to this, but I don't think this is it. I'm fairly certain this is not actually it, no. Running across this coastline. That's definitely not it. I'll scan it, but it's absolutely not this thing. So technically, I don't know that. I'm gonna pull up these maps again. Oops, that's not the right button. Because these maps don't have, like, water lines, waves drawn in any of the areas. So, like, theoretically, this doesn't have to be, like, water and land. This could be like a forest or a mountain or something shaped like that. We just have an outline. Don't know that it's necessarily coastline there. Same with this one. Will they both end up being coastline? Probably. But theoretically, them might be something else. There are a lot of things that have multiple flanges that could be the E, but the drawing is very regular. This is sort of shaped like the Blobby Island. But also, this is very irregular compared to the map. Yeah, I guess that was it. All right, so the map was misleading there. It was very smoothed off from what this island actually looks like. Messed up the scaling on this, but that's fine. Don't worry about it. Perfect replica. So that unfortunately suggests that we are also looking for something irregular for the letter E. It's not just the E, it's the E and there's also a little dot to the right of the middle bar there. It's probably not that because there's nothing over here. There's just mountains. Random forest. There was something here, so it's probably not that. And there's also like no dot there anyway. This landmass, dog. So we've got kind of an E here and kind of a dot all the way over here, but that seems like quite a stretch. I don't think this is it. More flanges here, but you just picked up something around here, so it's probably not that. I think in these mountains. Unclear. Cat. I guess I could be comparing the prices and seeing who will pay me more for this stuff, but that sounds like effort. It's a lot of money, but I don't think that's enough to buy either of the things that I wanted. I guess we will save here and check out Lay Hidden Village. Last week, this guy Gilmore hired us to find the Cloud Gate. And the elder here in this village gave us some information about it. But told us that we should actually bring it to him and not to Gilmore. But before we could betray Gilmore, Gilmore betrayed us and tased us and stole the Cloud Gate for himself. We got out betrayed. And I guess there was something about cards. Airship fight. Let's see if I remember which buttons to press during an airship fight. And just run into the enemies. Good. So far, this is just the same enemy showing up over and over again. Ow. Stop that. Alright, cool color change. Don't know if that's time based or wave based. Going a little fast here, just the answer to that question is yes. Oh, lightning effects, nice. All right, can we hit whatever these are? The answer may be no. About to lose an airship fight. By running into an enemy, good. now. I don't think, like I said before, I don't think I have enough money to afford the highest level hull upgrade or the second highest weapon upgrade. So if we do need an upgrade, we'll have to get not the max level. So hopefully we don't actually need to do that and waste our money. But we might have to do that and waste our money. It's the part where we get shot a lot. It's fine up to those enemies, at which point we get shot just a whole bunch of times and die. I'm just focusing entirely on the mini-map here and just trying to spray bombs, spray missiles in the general area they are, and hoping they fly into them as I back up. Thank you. Because the enemies do chase you. At least those ones that were shooting at me. So if I back up while firing, they'll, like, run directly into the bullets I'm firing. Also very slow, and we might time out of this mission. So we clearly need an upgrade of some sort. The problem is, I want that gun. We need to find a little bit more treasure in order to actually get that gun. Because the next two guns between there do not seem very good. I do not want a single shot weapon. So I'm sure not aiming. I don't know if this one will help. Is it a damage downgrade? Although maybe spraying bullets would help slightly? I don't know. What if there were more bullets on screen? I don't know if the treasures that we have that we could theoretically get will give us enough cash in order to the next weapon. I don't know if increasing our defense is going to help me kill them faster. It would be because then I would have to back up that much, but I don't know if that's the problem. It feels like a better gun would be more effective than being able to tank more hits. Because those later enemies do take quite a few hits before they actually die. I guess in that case, we are treasure hunting. We have this, we have the clue about the inland sea that looks like a face in profile. And then the clue about the angry sea god. Okay, I didn't think this was going to be it, but this is kind of E pointing to a dot. But would there have been a treasure like literally 2 feet away from the city? The answer appears to be no. Well, this kind of looks like a goofy comic character face. But we're not looking at this from the right direction. It says looking at it from the southeast, so that would be pointing like this, so that's definitely incorrect. Is that it? This is it. There's the face. Okay. Despair in the eyes and hope behind the nose. Got them treasures, nice. And that would be enough to get us to the gun. It's shooting time. All right, I forgot we get to play the mini game. Time to be a virtual girl again. Let's see how this goes with additional gun.
Okay.
Alright, so this one has a somewhat smaller bullet limit. But I think they're going a little further. Okay, this is a definite improvement because those things are dying way faster than they did before. Now. I can actually hit the thing. Hitting the thing is hard. It's probably not actually that hard. Oh, we're at the boss already, cool. Sometimes you just need to throw more gun at the problem until it goes away. Okay, so I guess there's another fight there. I feel like this is the one that we have already. Yeah, okay. We're not gonna spend another $500 on a clue I already have. Even though there's nothing else we can buy with this money. Checking if beating that fight unlocked any new treasures, but it doesn't seem like it. Absolutely no one here is saying anything different. Did I just land in the same place I went to already? I believe so. They definitely don't have any new intel if I go to the same place again. No new intel unlocked from that fight. So we just have the same two clues we had the last time. Alright, so I'm going to go get myself a glass of water. And when I get back, we'll see if we can find the road to sneak up on the angry sea god as well as the letter E. Stay tuned. for Zach. One of our two goals right now is we are trying to find the letter E. There is a treasure thereabouts. Also need to find the road to sneak up on the angry sea god, whatever that means. Oh, that didn't quite work. This dialogue seems to be having some issues. Maybe I'm going to save the video game here. I thought the road to the angry sea god. I mean, the full clue is that the ring shines on a cape, so we're looking at a cape of some sort. And I thought that that would be referring to this area here, the Doom Triangle, where every ship crashes. But we did scan all of the capes in this general area and didn't find anything. So it's some other mysterious cape. That probably exists somewhere in the video game. I guess this is it. Well, it's not the letter E. So why would this be the road to the angry sea god? Okay, well, apparently we found a thing, so now we just have the letter E left. The map is probably of a coastline, but we don't technically know that it's a coastline, so it could theoretically be like a mountain range shaped like an E, or forest or desert or something shaped like an E as well. Because that's probably just an abstract drawing, and it looks not as regular as that E does. It's not this, we checked this already though. Probably not this. I'm pretty sure I actually found something here earlier. I think this was a treasure last week. Not the river. I was kind of thinking maybe the river because I haven't really looked at it very closely, but no, it definitely does not do anything that seems E-like. Kind of thinking, I haven't really flown over this big mountain mass over here, so maybe in the middle of it there's something E-shaped? Doesn't really seem like it. Like, we've never actually landed on a mountain before. It's always been either grass, desert, or forest. I mean, like, theoretically, there could be a landing spot in the mountains. Is this it? Hold up. I've only ever looked at it from this side. So I was looking at the flanges, but if you rotate like this, there's an E over here with a dot. Is this it? Oh. Yeah, okay. So there's the E with the dot. I think every time I came through this way, I was facing at this angle, so I didn't notice that I was upside down. All right, we did it. We acquired the E. Title for this VOD will just be the E emoji. $9,000, $13,000. Oh, okay, this one is actually the counter dealer will give me more money for that ring than that guy would. Everything I checked both of them before, the other guy would buy it for more, but that is not always the case. That might be the last treasure in the game. I think that's the last treasure that we currently have access to. So if this is the final encounter, and there isn't another round that unlocks, that might have been the final treasure in the game. Interesting. Oh, can just leave. Just walk out. I haven't seen this before where the airship fight screen is in fact the hub to a different location. Very colorful background art here. All right. All right, I'm definitely not going outside. We got to stroll around for a little bit. All right, now we can go outside. Oh no, not in that normal situation. hate it when the situation is abnormal. Kinda. Can't activate the jukebox, shaking my head. This is a desperate time that calls for Music 6. Ooh, final stage. Got some lag going on here. Struggling a bit to keep up with this fight. So I just ate a whole lot of damage right there, but that's fine. We're not going to worry about it. I'm not entirely sure what was going on in that fight quite yet. But I think it's one of those fights where there are a bunch of stationary objects around the map and you need to destroy them all before you can hit the boss. Because I think there were some gem things that were spawning in once at a time. You're not 100% sure that's actually what was happening there, because we died pretty quickly. On the plus side, we can watch that guy get sucked into a cart again. Get owned, nerd. Literally Yu-Gi-Oh. Alright, so we need to figure out how to do that while not taking that much damage. I honestly wasn't really paying a whole lot of attention. I was just flying around and mashing buttons. So I'm not sure if I was taking damage from the boss snake that's flying around, or if I'm taking damage from the stationary gems, or both. The first step in not taking damage is to figure out what's damaging me. And then we can plan on how to not get hit by that. I'm also going to save state here this time so that we don't have to keep going through that cutscene again every time we lose to this fight. True, also. So I'm definitely taking a lot of damage from snake contact. Are there no more radar points? Is it vulnerable now? Maybe. Okay, I was hearing a noise there that I wasn't hearing before. I'm not positive if that was the boss taking damage. It might have been. We can hope it was. Safe state. Ow. Alright, well, there goes a fifth of my health immediately. Good. There are no more red radar arrows appearing on the screen, so... Wow, I just ran into the snake. Are those homing? There are occasional big black orbs that appear on screen. I thought they were projectiles, but they might actually be enemies I have to shoot. Not certain I'm actually hitting the boss at all. I think it wasn't quite in my bullet range there, so none of those shots were actually contacting it. I don't have enough money to get the best hull upgrade, but I think I probably have enough to go up one or two more steps, if necessary. All right, I'm already at 40% health. We're doing great. Ow. There's the orb again. Bullets do a lot of damage. Okay, I ran into the gem. Wasn't actually dead. Cool. Alright, maybe we'll try to buy a hull upgrade. And by try to buy a hull upgrade, I mean we'll fly completely past the town into oblivion. I guess we're buying the Carbide HX999. I'm a little concerned about it saying it's light and durable armor, because I don't know if that's just, you know, random item description, or if that means it'll actually affect my movement speed and make me go even faster. Oh, mini game time. Not sure that actually changed anything about my flight characteristics. Can't really tell if that was a difference. Let's see if this changes anything about this fight. All right. Okay, I think there's a definite difference in the amount of damage I'm taking. Are we hitting the thing? Unknown? Oh. Okay, well, I think we hit it. I'm not flying right now. This is cutscene. Same. I can't prove that I killed the boss and it didn't decide to just die on its own. Anyway. Cat. Parameters. Important. I love it when the game thanks me for my playing. All right, this might be one of those where it just stays on the screen forever. All right, well, we'll just do one more check through the towns. Oh. That's definitely not what this is supposed to be doing. Well, we're not going to worry about that. Because I went through the towns a bit, but I didn't do a full talk to every NPC, talk to every treasure counter to see if we... have any more treasures around somewhere. Seems like we got them all, but just to make absolutely sure we got them all. So we can't leave a single treasure unconflicted. Alright, there we go. See, the map is fine then. Cloud Temple. Base is over here. We can't actually go back to the water, I think. I think that I stopped being able to go underwater once we got the final treasure that was down there, but also it was really hard to actually find the place where you're supposed to dive anyway, so it's possible I'm just missing the 9 centimeter squared area where you can actually dive. We'll just assume that we can't dive anymore. So all the NPCs, after we beat the pirate guy in the first battle, talked about how, oh, the pirate's gunning for us now. He wants his revenge, and we never fought him again. Last town here. So it does indeed look like we got all of the treasures that we can currently access. It's possible that there was one that was temporarily available and got cut off as we progressed through the game. but no one is giving us any more treasure intel. So we'll just assume that that means we got all the treasures in the game. No, I don't think I saw that message before. He wants to shoot him with a gun. All right. So I guess that was treasure conflicts there. So I'm going to take down the stream for a bit so I can adjust my settings in OBS and change my resolution. When we'll start a PS1 game.